So it is not really based on strength yang PSM ada lah. So dia lihat ini sebagai skill saja, bukan policy. Yeah, I think they have a problem lah, the way they communicate. Actually, pada awalnya, before 2008, much easier because that time the fight is on BM, one party ruling. So the whole mood dalam gerakan pembangkang adalah unite against BM. Okay? Then tetapi kita lihat apabila kita nak discuss negotiation dengan kursi, begitu susah. Okay? Contohnya masa itu bila kita jumpa, Mat Sabu cakap saya tak ada masalah, saya sokong PSM. PSM pun sosialis, DAP pun sosialis, dia cakap PSM pun sosialis, mazhab lain. Masa tu Sabu dalam PAS. So masa tu dia tak ada masalah. DAP dalam meeting itu yang Tony Pua semua ada, dia cakap DAP have no problems working with PSM. Okay? Masa tu PKR ada problem. Dia hanya tengok kerusi, no? Kalau so it is not really based on strength yang PSM ada lah. So dia lihat ini sebagai state saja, bukan policy. So PSM was finally dicakap majlis presiden akan putuskan, yang tak pernah bincang pun. So they keep us in the waiting lah. And dia takkan hantar, dia takkan jawab soalan, dia takkan jawab surat. So this time 2022 ini, bila dia jawab soalan, saya beritahu dalam meeting pertama, ini satu perkembangan yang cukup dahsyat. Pertama kali you jawab soalan, you buat statement, you know. Ada, kita ada dapat surat daripada, oh, first time you are recognizing and you write a letter lah. So that shows the relationship dengan is very seat oriented, bukan policy oriented. And there was one time, suddenly Wan Azizah made a statement, PSM tidak dipanggil kerana PSM tak setuju dengan 153. Bagi kita shocking. Tak pernah PSM cakap pun benda itu. Ini pure labeling lah. Later they apologize. Wan Azizah all in private lah. Never, no public apology. But they make accusation like that lah. You know, we are against 153. Which is not true at all. Because our narrative was different. So I think in that sense, they keep you in the. That's why when Muda, PSM in the last election, we were quite actually, we know we are like not very hopeful, no. We already know how Pakatan is, and after Pakatan join dengan Mahathir especially, kita dah we had not much interest already, you know, and that time kita were alone. So bila dia buat deklarasi with Mahathir and all that, PSM was already opposed to them already. Because we find, you know lah, we can't accept orang yang kita lawan sama ini. Suddenly diangkat sebagai satu demokrat, you know. So diangkat sebagai seorang reformis. Itu kami tak boleh terima. Kalau, walaupun bagi kami, Mahathir ada, he's very progressive on a certain things. Melawan royalty or issue, I think Mahathir has got more guts than any other leader lah. Before that, you know, we recognize people for that. But politically speaking, dia gunakan, he misuse all the institusi against ramai kita. And then dia diangkat balik sebagai seorang reformis. That's the problem.